Evaluate. At this moment, I encourage you to pause the video and solve it by yourself. Okay, I will solve it now. So for k more or equal to 0, let's consider something what we have. This looks quite similar, each of those terms. This looks similar. So I'll continue. That will be equal 1 over square root of k plus 1 plus square root of k. I just switch those things in denominator. Now, at this moment, I don't like to have thirds in denominator. That's why I will multiply numerator and denominator by the conjugate of denominator. So I'll continue with 1 over square root of k plus 1 plus square root of k. And I will multiply numerator and denominator by the conjugate of denominator. This is the red thing. If I think about this, this is just 1, because the same thing divided by the same thing is 1. If I multiply by 1 expression, nothing will change. Now continue. Now in the numerator, 1 times those, that bracket is just square root of k plus 1 minus square root of k. And in denominator, I'm going to use formula a plus b times a minus b. So this is a squared minus b squared. So numerator again is the same. And denominator square root squared, so this will be just k plus 1 minus k. Now what I see, denominator k plus 1 minus k is just 1. So we divide by 1, so what we have, this is just equal k plus 1, square root of k plus 1 minus square root of k. Now what I proved that 1 over square root of k plus square root of k plus 1 for k more or equal to 0 is equal square root of k plus 1 minus square root of k. I proved this, and now I'm going to use this. So when I have my question, I will use what I calculated. So for the first term, 1 over square root of 0 plus square root of 0 plus square root of 1, using my formula which I found, this is equal square root of 1 minus square root of 0. That's the first term. The second term will be just plus second term now. This is equal, using the formula which I just found, square root of 2 minus square root of 1. The third term, this is equal plus again, and the third term will be just square root of 3 minus square root of 2. Continuing the same way, before last term is just 1 over, I can think about this, so what's the before last term? Is square root of 1 over square root of n minus 2 plus square root of n minus 1. So now I have plus plus, and before last term will be just square root of n minus 1 minus square root of n minus 2. And my last term will be just plus square root of n minus square root of n minus 1. When I think only about the first line, that square root of 1 will be simplified with that. That's 0, so we don't have it. That square root of 2 will be simplified with minus square root of 2. We don't have it. And in the first line, we have just square root of 3. What's left? So continuing the same way, square root of n minus 1, this one, will be simplified with this one. This square root of n minus 2 will go as well with somewhere here. So the answer for this question is just square root of n. I'm planning to create more videos, so do not forget to like and subscribe.